Shalom saudara dalam Tuhan, puji nama Tuhan, jumpa lagi dengan saya di kesempatan ini. Dan kiranya damai sejahtera daripada Tuhan Yesus melimpah bagi kita. Saudaraku dalam Tuhan, saya mengajak kita melihat satu cuplikan video di mana dalam video ini seorang gadis menceritakan kebaikan Israel kepada warga Gaza dan juga kepada warga Arab. Dan saudara dalam Tuhan, mari kita lihat videonya terlebih dahulu.
People don't know, but there each day there are tens of children and people from Gaza and from the West Bank being treated in Israeli hospital, receiving the best treatments for cancer and any other diseases. Israeli Jewish volunteers drive the parents back and forth from Gaza or from the West Bank. The niece of Ismail Haniya, who is the leader of Hamas, who is the brain behind this attack, she was hospitalized for a few months in Israel just recently. We give the best possible treatment for everyone. And you know Judaism really values lives, right? Like, what is the first tenet? Like, Al Tirtzach, right? Like, don't kill. We value life. We value human life. People don't know, but there are thousands of Gazan employees entering Israel every day to work through the Kerem Shalom checkpoint, right? It's the same place, border crossing, that the militants also used to infiltrate Israel. Thousands of them. They're working in Israel every day. Egypt didn't open its border to let the employment in. And they're calling Israel an apartheid. They're calling Israel making ethnic genocide. And this point is actually puzzling for me, because 25% of the Israeli population is actually Arabs. Most of them are Muslims. More than 20% are Muslims. I'm one of them, right? And so the Arabs in Israel are getting like equal rights, right? Like, they're citizens for everything, getting welfare, education, healthcare, anything that a Jewish citizen would get. So how can we call this an apartheid or committing ethnical genocide? And just as a personal story about myself, my mother, I was born to a Bedouin family. Bedouins are nomadic Arabs. Only 3% of them finished high school. My mother is penniless and illiterate. She doesn't know reading and writing because her parents didn't believe that women have the right to go to school. They should be on the fields and herd the sheep. Israel, after it was founded, it forced all children to go to school. It's like mandatory. And it couldn't stand that there are girls who are not getting educated. So they forced them. They literally went to my grandparents' house and forced them to send the girls to school. This is why my only two younger aunts know reading and writing. If not Israel today, probably I wouldn't be alive, because I also got death threats from my uncles. Because I was also the first ever Israeli Bedouin fashion model. But obviously he could not kill me, because like we're in Israel, right? Like, it's not like Israel protects women. If not Israel, I probably would be illiterate, penniless, herding sheep somewhere in Galilee, right? But I have electrical engineering degree. I have masters from Stanford University. And I have my rights to live my life the way that I wanted to live them. Right? As well, my mother was a single mom. She, I have 8, 9 siblings. It's a very long story from the same dad. And we lived on welfare. Israel gave us everything that it could give us, even though we were Arabs. And people are talking about apartheid and ethnical genocide. It just doesn't match the truth. It doesn't match the reality. They need to go and read the facts. And it's funny that sometimes it comes from intelligent students at elite universities saying this kind of nonsense. Thank you.
Baik, saudara dalam Tuhan, itu cuplikan videonya kita sudah simak apa yang disampaikan oleh seorang gadis Arab di video tadi. Dia menceritakan kebaikan daripada Israel, ya, mulai dari Israel tidak menolak warga Gaza dan juga warga Arab yang mau berobat kepada mereka. Mereka melayani dengan baik. Juga mereka menyekolahkan anak-anak saudara dalam Tuhan. Ya, sementara di daerah perempuan tadi sebenarnya katanya tidak terlalu penting bagi perempuan untuk sekolah, tapi Israel tidak seram Tuhan. Mereka menyekolahkan anak-anak baik perempuan maupun laki-laki, dan juga mereka menghargai sesama mereka manusia walaupun berbeda negara, suku, budaya dan segala macamnya. Kita lihat bagaimana perempuan tadi mengatakan kalau bukan karena dia berada di Israel, mungkin saat ini dia sudah tidak ada lagi karena dia mau dibunuh oleh keluarganya sendiri. Tetapi oleh karena dia berada di Israel, maka Israel menjaganya. Dalam Tuhan, ya, saudara dalam Tuhan, ini sangat luar biasa. Dan perempuan tadi juga mengutip Alkitab di dalam kitab Taurat tentang Taurat Musa, yaitu jangan membunuh. Artinya bahwa Israel menghargai sesama mereka, ya, saudara dalam Tuhan. Inilah kebaikan-kebaikan bangsa Israel yang diceritakan oleh seorang perempuan tadi. Jadi kalau di luar sana ada orang yang berkata bahwa Israel tidak baik, Israel begini begitu, terlalu kejam dan segala macamnya, ya saya katakan terserah mereka. Tapi lihat ini, buka mata lebar-lebar saudara dalam Tuhan, ya, lihat apa yang disampaikan oleh perempuan tadi. Dan di video saya sebelumnya juga saya upload satu video yang menceritakan kebaikan Israel di sisi lain. Dan saudara Tuhan, sangat luar biasa sekali, ya, banyak orang yang hari-hari ini cerita tentang kebaikan Israel, ya, bahkan di tengah-tengah persoalan antara mereka dengan Palestina beberapa hari yang lalu, saudara, ada warga Palestina yang berobat ke Israel lalu mereka tidak menolaknya, saudara Tuhan. Dan itu pun saya bahas di video saya sebelum-sebelumnya. Ya, saudara bisa cek lah video-video saya sebelumnya dan saudara bisa menemukan di sana bagaimana warga Israel ini melakukan kebaikan, ya, kebaikan untuk manusia, terhadap Tuhan, ya, kebaikan kemanusiaan bagi warga Arab dan juga warga Gaza sendiri atau warga Palestina. Terhadap Tuhan, ini sangat luar biasa sekali. Sekali lagi, ya, jangan kita berpikir terlalu jauh terhadap bangsa Israel. Mari kita berpikir positif tentang bangsa Israel, bahwa bangsa Israel adalah bangsa yang diberkati Tuhan, umat pilihan Tuhan, dan juga yang punya hati, ya, yang mau menolong sesama saudara Tuhan. Ya, dan saudara Tuhan, kiranya video tadi memberikan kita satu pemahaman baru, memberkati kita dan membuat kita sadar bahwa pikiran negatif kita terhadap Israel tidak selalu benar adanya. Dan kiranya video singkat ini memberkati kita, dan Tuhan Yesus memberkati kita semua. Shalom.